other delegate to join fast.
Okay. Fine. Now,
My name is
Yes, delegate of Nigeria. Thank you so much, Delegate of Nigeria. Now, Delegate of France, you're recognized. Which motion you'd like to raise? How much time you want, Delegate?
1 minute.
Delegate, you're recognized. Please establish yourself.
South China Sea is a region of the world's maritime
Delegate, you are recognized. Please establish yourself.
Girl child education goes beyond getting girls into school. It's also about ensuring that girls learn and feel safe while in school, complete all levels of education with the skills to effectively compete in the labor market, learn the social, emotional, and life skills necessary to navigate and adapt to a changing world, make decisions about their own lives and contribute to their communities and the world. The Department of Education of the Government of Spain is recognized for its project SCOE, Growing Inequality, which addresses gender stereotypes in education and beyond, with a holistic school program that empowers learners to choose their course in life. It promotes an environment free of gender conditioning and enables learners to identify inequalities, fight them, and exercise their individual rights to equality regardless of their gender. In 2017, the project was first piloted in 16 schools, later extended to 116 establishments, and is now scheduled to cover all schools in the province by 2021. As far as what Spain is doing to promote girl child education in Africa is concerned, Spain has signed an MOU with NEPAD to create the NEPAD Spanish Fund for African Women Empowerment. The key areas supported by the Spanish funding include education, health, promotion of economic fabric, as well as...
Thank you. I would like to raise motion on the fifth sub-agenda concerning Israel's take on the girl child education in Africa and Asia. And this is about gender discrimination. So the state of Israel was established in 1948 by the Declaration of Independence, which promises full social and political rights to all of Israel's citizens, regardless of religion, race, or gender. Even as the state continued to struggle for its very existence through its early decades, and even as Israel continues to face existence and threats, legislation promoting women's equality and human rights has been a central part of the Israeli society. Israel has progressive gender laws, however, they are neither enforced nor properly regulated. As a result, gender discrimination and inequality remains a major issue. Societal actors must pressure.
Contemporary international relations literature is a pursuit of national security in spite of its ambitions, indefinitions, and scope of reference. Indeed, since existence of one state comes through acceptance by another state of state, it interacts with the legitimacy of the state and all it claims to present is throughout history. A conscientious matter among those areas of contention, the geographical scope of policies, the population and resources by a state is probably the most obvious. The South China Sea provides an excellent case of such contentions. For centuries, the South China Sea remains the stateless occupation of the Iceland and Atoll Totti. Its waters was in the 17th through early 20th centuries. At best, a minor issue of concern to European colonizers whose main interest lay in countries East Asia. It began to affect the evolution of inter-state relations. East Asia only after the end of colonization first by Europe and later a brief occupation in 1940 by Japan.
Threats and non-traditional threats, such as piracy, drugs, illegal migration, and terrorism. These factors have converged over territorial disputes in the South China Sea. The South China Sea contains three main areas of contested territory, the Spratly Islands, the Paracel Islands, and Scarborough Shoal. The South China Sea also represents the strategic waterway of global significance, providing the key maritime link between the Indian and Pacific Oceans. One of the key factors Behind the increased need for greater maritime military capabilities has been the changes in ocean governance legislation that gives coastal states greater sovereignty over the coastal and adjoining waters. German military presence in the Indo-Pacific is the interest of the German naval leadership, which has wished for such an operation for some time. It's also a signal to soldiers that German maritime influence is not constrained to the Baltic Sea and the Mediterranean. Germany has been concerned about China's economic slowdown. China and Germany.